your loved one has had a poor credit history that's been riddled with late or missed payments, they may face trouble in qualifying for a loan or credit card and ask you to co-sign for them. While banks prefer not to approve loan applications coming from these kind of applicants, these applications can still beat the odds if the applicant can get someone with a good credit history to co-sign with them. Relatable? I guess you are one of them who was approached to co-sign by your loved one. But there are a few things that you need to keep in mind before you sign the dotted line. Hey guys, this is Prarthana from ClearTax, and it's time that we talk about the 5 things that you should know before co-signing a loan for someone else. Number 1, your loved one needs a co-signer because they don't qualify for a loan alone. There's a clear reason why your loved one needs you to co-sign a loan with them, and that is they're not creditworthy, or at least the banks don't deem them to be so. If the bank needs a co-signer, it is likely that they think that your loved one will not be able to repay the loan on his own. Number 2, you won't benefit from the loan. When you co-sign a loan, your loved one would actually be the one who is benefiting from the loan. They would be living in the house, driving the car, etc. You won't have the loan amount at your disposal or be able to make use of it. If the repayments on the loans are done on time, having this loan on your account may boost your credit score. But your credit score probably doesn't need that much attention if you can qualify as a co-signer. So maybe it's not worth the risk. Number 3, payments on the co-signed account will affect you. When you co-sign, you are just as responsible for the repayments as if it was yours alone. You may not have access to the loan amount and will not be able to use it to fund your purchases, but if your loved one is late on payments, these will show up on your credit report too. The late payments will affect your credit score and impact your ability to get approved for loans. Number 4, your level of debt increases. As mentioned earlier, the loan that you co-sign for will appear as debt on your credit history too and will affect your loan-to-income ratio. Thus, when a bank reviews your application for a loan or credit card, they would be taking this debt too into consideration and then determine your worthiness to qualify for additional loans. If the co-signed loan makes your debt-to-income ratio too high, this might hinder your chances of being approved for a loan or a credit card. Last but not the least, you are responsible for repayment if your loved one defaults on the loan. When you co-sign a loan, you are taking on the responsibility of making repayments if your loved one misses out on or fails to make any repayments. In fact, your loved one may still be able to get off the hook by claiming bankruptcy, but the lender will then come after you for repayments for this loan. It may take you years to get a negative entry removed from your credit report. Before you decide to co-sign, remember to assess and weigh in on the risk that your credit profile would become vulnerable to. Thank you for watching the video. If you have any more doubts or recommendations, definitely let us know in the comment section below. Also, don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up and maybe share it with a friend or a family member who might be needing to watch this video. Stay subscribed to ClearTax's YouTube channel for regular videos on finance. Stay tuned and take care.